RENO Quick Start Guide Chapter 9, Risk Analysis, Event Tree for Risk of Fire Damage. Event trees are analyses that help you to examine the possible outcomes of a series of subsequent events and trace the pivotal events that lead to a specific end result. In this chapter, you will explore two ways to create event trees in RENO. The first method uses fixed probabilities. The second method uses simulation. Event tree example. You are evaluating a building's fire suppression system. The system relies on two subsystems, a sprinkler system and an automatic notification system that calls the fire station. If the sprinkler system is not engaged and the fire station is not called, the building is likely to be destroyed. If one of the subsystems fails to react, but the other subsystem succeeds, the building is likely to be partially damaged. Your research indicates that there is a 10% chance of fire, a 60% chance of the alert system calling the fire station, and a 70% chance of the sprinklers working. Objectives: use a discrete event tree analysis approach to estimate the probabilities for three different outcomes: the probability that the building will have no damage, the probability that the building will be partially damaged, and the probability that the building will be destroyed. Use a simulation approach to solve for the same three outcomes and compare the results. Note: instead of creating your own project, you can open the 7 Risk Analysis Event Tree for Risk of Fire Damage project and the Quick Start repository to see the RENO flowchart that is created in this chapter. Discrete Event Tree Analysis. Define the resources. The first step is to define the variables for the given probabilities. Open the Resource Manager by choosing Project, Synthesis, Resource Manager. You click Variables in the navigation panel and then choose Home, Edit, New. Name the variable probFire and specify an initial value of 0.1. Select the Reset After Analysis option as shown. Follow similar steps to create the probCallFireStation variable with initial value equal to 0.6 and the probSprinklerWorks variable with initial value equal to 0.7. Build the flowchart. The next step is to create a flowchart model of the problem. Here is an overview of how the final flowchart will work: fixed probability and the sample project. The flowchart uses binary nodes to branch the analysis into different paths. Each path shows the pivotal events that lead to a specific end result. To create this flowchart model, you first use a standard block to represent the starting point for each simulation. Name the block Start and then enter the value 1 in the equation field. This value represents the 100% probability that there will be an outcome to the situation and will serve as the incoming value for the first binary node that follows. Create a binary node to calculate the probability of fire. Enter the probFire variable into the condition is true TPath field as shown. The binary node will have two outputs, true and false. The output for the true path will be the incoming value, 1, multiplied by the value of the probFire variable, 0.10. The output for the false path will be the incoming value, 1, multiplied by the complement value of the probFire variable, 0.9. In other words, the blocks true path will pass the probability that a fire will occur, and its false path will pass the probability that a fire will not occur. You create another binary node to calculate and pass the probabilities that the sprinkler system will work, true path, or won't work, false path. This time, you enter the prob sprinkler works variable into the condition is true tpath field as shown. Add another binary node to calculate and pass the probabilities that the alarm system will work, true path, or won't work, false path. In this block, you enter the prob call fire station variable into the condition is true tpath field as shown. To create a second instance of the same node to be connected to the false path from the sprinkler worked node, simply copy and paste the block into the appropriate location. Next, create 5 result storage blocks to average the results from the 5 paths in the flowchart. The properties for all 5 blocks are identical except for the block name. As an example, this shows the properties for the no fire outcome. The next step is to connect the blocks. You enter the Connect Blocks mode by choosing Flowchart, Settings, Connect Blocks. You then connect the blocks as shown. For the true and false paths from each binary node, you make sure to draw the true path first to ensure that the path is properly identified in the flowchart. A true path is green with a T above the line, while a false path is red with an F above the line. Tip: if you accidentally connect the blocks in the wrong order, you can either delete both lines and start over, or change the designations by right-clicking the connector and choosing Set to Failure or Set to Success on the shortcut menu. Simulate the flowchart. Finally, click the Simulate icon on the control panel to open the RENO simulation window. Enter 1 for the number of simulations and specify to use a seed of 1 for repeatability. You need only 1 simulation because the binary nodes will model all 5 discrete sequences of events with a single pass through the flowchart. Click Simulate to start the simulation. When simulation is complete, you close the window to return to the flowchart. The values of the result storage blocks are displayed in the flowchart. The results show that there is a 90% chance of a fire not occurring, and there is a 4.2% chance that both the sprinkler and alarm systems will successfully work. This results in a 94.2% chance that the building will have no damage. There is a 2.8% chance that the sprinkler will work, but the alarm system will not. There is also a 1.8% chance that the sprinkler will not work, but the alarm system will. This results in a 4.6% chance that the building will be partially damaged. There is a 1.2% chance that the building will be destroyed because both the sprinkler and alarm failed. Event tree analysis using simulation. The next step is to solve for the same 3 outcomes with a simulation approach that uses conditional blocks instead of binary nodes. Typically, simulation is recommended for cases where you don't have the exact probability data, only models. With this approach, each pass through the flowchart results in only 1 of the 5 possible sequences of events, and the results are compiled from the outcomes of a large number of simulations to estimate the probability that each event will occur. Define the resources. First, open up the Resource Manager by choosing Project, Synthesis, Resource Manager. Select RENO functions in the navigation panel. Then, create a new RENO function that will convert the probability value stored in the probfire variable into a percentage, that is 10% instead of 0.10, as shown. You follow similar steps to create the prob call fire station percent function and the prob sprinkler works percent function. Build the flowchart. You will use the same structure you used in the previous flowchart, but this time you will use conditional blocks instead of binary nodes. To save time, begin by duplicating the original flowchart, fixed probability in the sample project. You do this by right-clicking the folio in the current Project Explorer and choosing Duplicate on the shortcut menu. Once the duplicate folio is created, rename it to distinguish it from the original flowchart, simulation, and the sample project. Next, delete the first binary node, called fire. Replace it with a new conditional block. The new block has the properties shown. Here, the FP is less than or equal to percent condition configures the conditional block to ignore any incoming values. Instead, the block will draw a random number uniformly distributed from 0 to 100 and then evaluate whether that number is less than or equal to the condition value, that is, whether the random number is less than or equal to 10%. Unlike the binary node, this conditional block is configured to have only one output, true or false. If the condition is true, then a fire occurred and the simulation sends a value of 1 to the true path. If the condition is false, then a fire did not occur and the simulation sends a value of 1 to the false path. You follow similar steps to replace the remaining binary nodes with new conditional blocks. For the result storage blocks, you configure them to calculate the sum of results instead of the average, as shown here for the no-fire outcome. After you have restored all of the connections to and from the new conditional blocks, the completed flowchart looks like this. Simulate the flowchart. You open the RENO simulation window and run 1,000 simulations with a seed of 1 for repeatability. When simulation is complete, you close the window to return to the flowchart. The results show that 942 of the 1,000 simulations, 94.2%, result in no fire damage. 43 of the 1,000 simulations, 4.3%, result in partial damage. In 15 of the 1,000 simulations, 1.5%, the building is destroyed. The results show that both methods yield similar results, but with some minor differences due to the random numbers generated by the conditional blocks. Increasing the number of simulations will result in a solution that equals the analytical solution you obtained using the binary nodes. This concludes RENO Quick Start Guide Chapter 9. Thank you for watching.